For the biacromial breadth measurement, the subject sits upright with a noticeable curvature in the lower back. The shoulders are relaxed with the hands resting on the lap. The technician stands behind the subject. The shaft of the broad blade caliper rests at the base of the thumb and index finger of both hands. The technician uses the middle fingers to palpate the ridges of the acromial processes. When the lateral borders of the acromial processes are located, the bars of the sliding caliper are placed directly on them. The shaft of the caliper is aligned parallel to the shoulders. Pressure is applied to compress the soft tissue without inducing pain. The maximal breadth across the lateral borders of the acromial processes is measured in centimeters to the nearest millimeter. Biiliac breadth is taken while the subject is standing upright with the feet together and the waist area exposed. The technician stands behind the subject, resting the large sliding caliper between the thumb and index finger of each hand. Using the middle fingers, the uppermost lateral borders of each ilium on the mid-axillary line are located on both sides of the body. The arms of the sliding caliper are placed on the lateral borders of the ilium, and the soft tissue is compressed firmly. The maximum breadth is measured to the nearest millimeter. For elbow breadth, the subject stands facing the technician. The right arm is extended forward and is flexed, so the upper arm and forearm form a 90-degree angle at the elbow. The fingers point up, with the posterior part of the wrist toward the technician. While holding the caliper between the thumb and index finger of each hand, the technician palpates the epicondyles of the elbow with the middle fingers. The blades of the caliper are applied to the epicondyles at a 45-degree angle to the plane of the long axis of the upper arm. The soft tissue is compressed firmly. This measurement is taken with the calipers at a slight angle because the medial epicondyle is slightly more distal than the lateral epicondyle. The greatest breadth across the epicondyles of the humerus is measured to the nearest millimeter. The wrist breadth is measured with the subject standing. The subject extends the right arm directly to the front, with the palm of the hand down. The small sliding caliper is held between the thumb and index finger of each hand. The technician palpates the most prominent aspects of the styloid processes of the ulna and radius with the middle fingers. The caliper blades are placed on these landmarks, and firm pressure is applied to compress the soft tissues. The wrist breadth is recorded to the nearest millimeter. A head circumference measurement is taken on children ages 2 months through 7 years. A plasticized insertion tape is used to measure head circumference. The infant is held on the lap of the parent or assistant technician. Older children may sit or stand unassisted. Any hair ornaments or any hair arrangements, such as braids, that may interfere with the accuracy of the measure should be removed. The technician stands to the right side of the child. The insertion tape is placed around the head. On the face, the lower margin of the measuring tape is placed just above the eyebrows. On the sides of the head, the tape extends above the ears to the back of the skull, where it's centered over the occipital prominence. While holding the tape in place over the eyebrows, the tape is moved up or down as necessary on the posterior aspect of the skull. The objective is to locate the maximal circumference of the head at the occipital prominence. The enlarged portion of the measuring tape that contains the window where the reading is taken should be laid flat on the side of the head. The two ends of the measuring tape should be pulled firmly to compress the hair and the underlying soft tissues. The measurement is recorded to the nearest millimeter.